challenger Herschel Walker will duke it out in a special runoff election yesterday. Former President Barack Obama campaigned for Senator Warnock, while Senator Tim Scott attended events for Walker. Nearly 2 million people have already cast ballots through early voting in that race. And this is brand new video as well as sound that actually just came into the Channel 3 newsroom of a powerful tremor that resulted from a 6.7 magnitude earthquake that struck between American Samoa and Tonga.
Give me a fart, Daddy.
No, I can't right now. If I fart, I might poop my pants.
Uh-oh, are you going to change?
I thought you were going to change, but I have to change if he poops his pants. Did Lindsay send you any videos of Kendall?
What?
Did Lindsay send you any videos of Kendall?
No.
Not yet.
Learned last night that he has been voted into the Hall thanks to a unanimous vote by the Contemporary Baseball Era
But hopefully I will tomorrow. Okay. Hopefully it will today.
Okay.
And we're going to continue to track these developing stories for you, and we'll have another update for the breaking news that's coming up in the next hour. Scott?
All right, thanks, Roger. 5:45 is now the time. How we go, our Doppler drive, you're going to do some scraping of the ice off the windshields this morning.
This guy reminds me of
Rock. Yeah, it's a nice frosty start up there for you. But the roads are dry, you're good to go. They've got a major problem on I-84 in West Hartford. You're going to want to pay attention to coming up in just a couple of minutes, so stay tuned for that. In the meantime, early morning future cast does bring in some cloud coverage this afternoon. That's about it, though. We stay dry during the day today. Tomorrow morning, you wake up to mostly cloudy skies. So today, we start off.
I figured as much, because Mom's like, oh, he's going to be home by like 7:30. And I was like, what is that?
Wednesday morning, it's pouring.
How would she know?
Wednesday morning. Impacted with rain. It doesn't look as windy.
They're always the kind of at home with quarter nine.
Folks, typical overnight low for the time of year is about 28. We've got that view in Waterbury, Bridgeport, and Chester, but everybody else falls short. Torrington just by 1 degree, but we are down from yesterday. 4 to 16 degrees cooler in parts of the state than where we were just 24 hours ago. Yesterday was a beautiful day. Saturday, not so much. The winds are calm. No wind chill out there this morning. A little bit of a visibility issue at Brainerd Airport this morning. They're down to 2 miles of visibility, 7 miles in New Haven, so you might encounter a little bit of fog, but I'm not picking it up here on our Hartford iCam with 22 degrees. That's a chilly start. Oh, Christmas tree, how lovely are thy branches. It is stunning in New Haven this morning. And according to our satellite and radar, we're good. So let's jump ahead here. We know it's going to rain tomorrow afternoon. Thursday, we get a little bit of a break. This is Thursday, according to one model. Now, as we run down this model run, this is the European. It keeps us high and dry through the weekend. Let's vote for this model run, because this other model run, GFS, well, this is Thursday. You'll notice rain rolls in 1 o'clock in the afternoon on Friday. It's pouring during the day on Friday and Saturday, looking wet. And then Saturday evening, it starts to wind down. But this is the worst of the two scenarios. So we're still, the models are not in agreement. We'll keep you posted as to Friday and Saturday. In the meantime, enjoy today. Calm and quiet to start. A really lovely day of weather.
As much as it sickens my stomach, he's right.
Nice
sunny Tom was for a year from the very
beginning.
He fucked himself over when he went to the E9.
Low 50s. So a real nice day of weather. Once again, 43 to 52 is the spread. And then your 7-day forecast includes some rain tomorrow night. Wednesday looks like a super soaker, but a mild day, 57 degrees. 51 on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, subject to change. We're going optimistically dry right now. Sunday, 43 degrees, so we'll be trending cooler over the upcoming weekend. I'm staying optimistic. John Genio is 33 today. Katie Petrella, 34.
Stop! Stop! Excuse me!
Get the calendar,
carry
the waters.
There's something.
Calendar, it's $15. This is a great fundraiser for Gary. Just 85 to 90 animals that all need special attention.
So, we have a traffic issue. She's waiting to ship her
stocking stuffers and your gifts for your coworkers or whatever that makes you happy. Get a copy for yourself. $15. Go to allergypasture.org. Thanks, Carrie, for all the hard work you're doing. We're happy to promote the calendar.
Mm-hmm. Really had a rough
day. Especially since all that money goes to
It's
a total disaster. I know, it's so unfortunate. This is really going to hang a lot of people up on their morning commutes here today. So here is your warning that you're going to need to budget in tons of extra travel time if you're heading 84 westbound in towards the West Hartford area, or maybe if you're traveling past the West Hartford area, you're traveling through the Capital City region here this morning, and this is going to be really problematic. So drive times and speeds might look like they're typical.
That happens.
So just heads up on that. West Hartford is shut down, 84 westbound between exits 44 and 43 because of a multi-vehicle crash. We do have some video from earlier that I think we can roll for you. So this is, again, this is from earlier this morning.
Absolutely.
Through one of our DOT cameras. Unfortunately, they pulled the live feed for us, but this is a look at what was taking place just a short time ago, and you can see that area completely blocked off. This is going to cause, again, a huge issue for that morning commute because it's going to take quite some time for this to clear. We will keep you posted on any developments surrounding this incident throughout the morning commute, so just make sure that you keep it tuned in here to Channel 3, the app, and I'm updating social as well, so just make sure that you keep checking and drive safely as you're heading out the door. I'm Caitlin Francis with your Connecticut Chevy Traffic Report, driven by your Connecticut Chevy.
All right,
thanks for that. It is now